cathedral, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ, a little child.
Beloved in Christ, in this season of Advent and leading into Christmastide, let it be our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even to Bethlehem to see the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by his holy child. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of his birth with hymns and songs of praise. And let us make this Pro-Cathedral Church dedicated to Mary, Blessed Mother of our Lord, glad with carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of God's whole world, for peace and goodwill over all the earth. Pray for the mission and unity of the church for which he died, and especially in this land of Anguilla and within this town of the valley. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God his pure and lowly mother, and all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in this Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself has taught us to say when we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
God tells sinful Adam that he lost the life of paradise and that his seed will bruise the serpent's head. Now, the serpent was more crafty than any other wild animal that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say, 'You shall not eat from any tree in the garden?'" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden." But God said, "You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the middle of the garden, nor shall you touch it, or you shall die." But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to me to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's go. Okay. Go on. Go on. Did you know that your baby boy has promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all nations of the earth be blessed. After these things, God tested Abraham. He said to him, Abraham, and he said, here I am. He said, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I shall show you. So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him, and his son Isaac. He cut the wood for the burnt offering, and set out and went to the place in the distance that God had shown him. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place far away. Then Abraham said to his young men, stay here with the donkey. The boy and I will go over there. We will worship, and then we will come back to you. Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac, and he himself carried the fire and the knife. So the two of them walked on together. Isaac said to his father, Abraham, father? And he said, here I am, son. He said, the fire and the wood are here, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Abraham said, God himself will provide the lamb for a burnt offering, my son. So the two of them walked on together. When they came to the place that God had shown him, Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham! And he said, here I am. He said, do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me. And Abraham looked up and saw a ram caught in a thicket by its horns. Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called the place, the Lord will provide, as it is said to this day, on the mount of the Lord it shall be provided. The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, by myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore, and your offspring shall possess the gate of the enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice. Thanks be to God.
the gifts of wealth, betrothed to me. Did you see how they bowed as they praised him alone at his birth? Did you hear how the choirs of angels sang at the glory?
The prophet Isaiah foretells the coming of the Savior. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. You have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. The peace of Christ is being foreshown. A shoot shall come out of the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth and with the breath of his lips. He shall not kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put its hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Thanks be to God.
the angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin and tells her that she will bear the Son of the Most High. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I'm a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Your baby boy will one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy who save our sons and daughters.
Did you know that your baby boy is come to make you new?
That your baby boy will give sight to a blind man. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand?
Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod?
Saint Luke tells of the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their towns to be registered. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of the city David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who expected a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The shepherds go to the manger. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was the angel. And suddenly, there was the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angel had left and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. Thanks be to God.
With a baby inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry.
wise men are led by the star to Jesus. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Thanks be to God.
Once upon a Christmas, far away in Bethlehem, Mary, being great with child, had no place to lie down. So Joseph found a stable in which Mary had her child. Once upon a Christmas was the birth of Jesus Christ.
Once upon a Christmas, in a manger far away, a king was born in his palace, was an angel filled with hay. His royal robe was swaddling clothes, a halo was his crown. Once upon a Christmas, away in rejoice because a king was born at last. A savior had been promised, now it has come to pass. And the joyful news that he was born spread. spread quickly far and wide. Once upon a Christmas was the birth of Jesus Christ.
Once upon a Christmas, from the far east wise men came, with gold and myrrh and frankincense, to praise the newborn king.
And the shepherds left their flocks and came to see and worship him. Once upon a Christmas, away in Bethlehem. And all the world rejoiced because the king was born at last. A savior had been promised, now it had come to pass. And the joyful news that he was born spread quickly far and wide. Once upon a Christmas, and the birth of Jesus Christ.
All stand. St. John unfolds a great mystery of the incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Standing for a few moments just to say thanks to one and all for coming and sharing with us in this festival of lessons and carols. We thank you for your presence here, and it has indeed been a blessing for all of us to share in this very special service. We want to say thanks, and I ask you to put your hands together for all our performers, those who sang in the choirs. Those who dance or dancers, especially the two little ones, let's give them a big round of applause. very, very heartening. We want to say thanks as well to all those who read the lessons. We thank you very much, those who serve as electors. And we say very special thanks as well to the St. Mary's Sunday School for the very interesting presentation of the Cherry Tree Carol. Could we give them a round of applause, please? Now, Mr. Webb and Kelsick, Tamika, creating the poster, Celestine, our doorkeeper, Bishop, we want to thank you for the collect and the blessing. We want to thank Jean as well. Saw Jean somewhere. Jean, you're still here? Celebrating the Chiefs won today. Jean, responsible for printing the program. Thanks to Ingrid as well for contacting the readers, making sure that everything was in place for today. Ivor and Joanne, we want to thank them for recording the service. We were not live today, but the service has been recorded, and it will be placed on our Facebook page as well as YouTube at a later date. Anytime, what time will we have it there? By tomorrow, Ivor? By tonight. By tonight, it will be recorded. Could we put our hands together for all those persons who have been mentioned? I don't think I've missed anyone, but once again, thanks to one and all for your involvement in tonight's service. Bishop?
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that as we joyfully receive him for our Redeemer, so we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our judge, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. Amen. Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one all things earthly and heavenly, grant you the fullness of inward peace and goodwill, and make you partakers of the divine nature, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this night and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
He is born, and we wish you a Merry Christmas.
Yeah. with you.
Let us go in peace to love each other and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. He is born. Yes, he is born. Jesus the Savior is born. Bishop, thank you.